What up, and welcome to OMRPG. Today we got a super special episode. We're going to be doing an interview with one of the voice actors from Luigi's Mansion 3, a new game from Nintendo. Today we've got with us Bill William Hoover, who plays Luigi's faithful sidekick and weapon, the Poltergust G00. Bill, thank you so much for joining us today. It's an honor to have you on. Oh, thank you very much. Super glad that you liked our previous videos. So, I have to ask, what was it like working with the incomparable Luigi? Oh, really? Now that's some juicy information. Do you mind expanding a bit on that? Oh my. Yikes. And you say he gave that look to the crew? I think we have that on file somewhere. Can we pull that? Oh yeah, that's it. The famous Luigi stink eye. Oh yeah, I bet he was. And you say this all started as a prank war? Amazing. Well, you heard it first here on OMRPG. I know Luigi loves a good prank, and I think it's absolutely hilarious that you guys pranked him back. Yep, absolutely a pleasure. Thank you again. So I guess there's no better time than for a quick review of this game. Does it live up to the hype? Is it as good as the previous Luigi's Mansion games? Is it a must-have for the Nintendo? We'll find out right after the break. Wait, what do you mean there's no break? I mean, all right. Okay, fair enough. Well, yes, this game is freaking awesome! Luigi's Mansion 3 is an incredible addition to the series, bringing some innovative puzzle designs and interesting stage variety to the table. The first game was an awesome adventure on the GameCube, the second was a nice bite-size offering on the 3DS, and this third one is a fantastic trek up a tall and impressive hotel. Graphics are gorgeous, a bit on the cartoony Fortnite side, but it's an awesome palette and a gorgeous environment. The textures are simple but effective, while the color palette is perfectly balanced throughout the various levels, most of which offer a unique biome from earlier stages you play through. These variations in levels start when you unlock the sixth floor of the hotel, which is accomplished by finding new level buttons for the elevators once you've defeated a floor's main boss. This is a great change in pace and helps breathe fresh life into each new floor you unlock. The gameplay is both familiar and refreshingly new as well. If you've played any of the previous titles, you will recognize most of the controls right off, but there are also a slew of new control concepts introduced that greatly ramp up the fun in exploration and combat. The introduction of motion controls is definitely welcome, even if they can be somewhat unfinished. While you're able to use motion controls to move your weapon and light up and down, the lack of being able to go from side to side is a bit odd, and using the light to uncover hidden secrets without the ability to move in those directions can be kind of frustrating. Seems to be a missed opportunity. But that complaint aside, I still prefer having some motion controls over having none. The addition of Luigi lends a truly unique gameplay mechanic to the overall experience. It takes a bit of time in-game before you unlock this new feature, but it's absolutely worth the wait. You can use Luigi as a second Luigi, even using them together to solve specific puzzles. This version of Luigi can squeeze through slotted walls, gates, and set pieces of the like, but he is extremely vulnerable to water and will be temporarily destroyed if he comes in contact with it. It's a really fun way to add difficulty to puzzles and was an awesome surprise when he was introduced into the game. The puzzles are a bright spot in the overall Luigi's Mansion 3 experience. It feels like the game is about 50% puzzles, with 40% being boss fights and the other 10% being small ghost encounters. This may seem like an odd ratio, but the boss fights are frequent and, for the most part, extremely fun and entertaining. The piano ghost boss fight is one of the best examples. It was a truly hard and rewarding experience with multiple stages to the battle. These boss fights are all very unique, and I was always excited to see what new trick the devs would ask you to figure out in order to combat these crazy and unique characters. So you gain money from sucking up just about anything, but it takes a bit of a while before you even open up the shop, where you'll spend your hard-earned cash. You do get a few really cool items to help you along in the rest of the game, so I ain't mad at it. Gem finders and boo finders are super helpful if retrieving all the secret little hidey guys is something you're into. And you even have the ability to buy bones for your little ghost doggo that will activate and refill your life were you to reach 0 hit points or hearts. And this doggo...
super cute.
Even if he eats human food? What? What? The characters are all super adorable and fun. I mean, this lady's voice is a bit, yeah, okay. Oh, and is it just me or does Dr. Igad sound like a Jawa? I'm cool with it. The music is also a shining example of Nintendo excellence and provides a very nice backdrop for each level. I was definitely jamming out to some of these tracks as I went through levels. This game may take a hot minute to really get started though, and I remember spending most of the first night's playthrough just getting through the intro and setup of the game. Even though this was the case, it was still entertaining enough to suck me in. Vacuum joke there. Get it? Suck me in? And by the time I was able to get back in for more of my playthrough, I was invested in the story, the characters, and the setting. Luigi's Mansion 3 is indeed an amazing effort by Nintendo to extend this IP for Switch owners, and I've enjoyed almost every minute of the playthrough. Great AAA game on one of my favorite modern consoles. I give this one a yeah, that's some good junk, Batman. 5.5 thumbs up. Give me some more. All right, that's it for Luigi's Mansion 3. If you liked the video, subscribe, hit that like button. We out. Peace.